taking a look. Wow, that's a really nice checkmate. Antoine Musa against Captain Price, a bullet war. Why did my camera become foggy? Okay, it's back to normal. That was weird. So yeah, barely caught the first game. Maybe we'll go over it very quickly. Or not. Let's stay with this game. Alright, so what do we have? A Caro-Kann, yes. Antoine is a Caro-Kann player. We're seeing the advanced variation with c3. Alright. This is looking more and more like a good kind of variation of the French. Okay, this f6, f5 is a bit strange, kind of wasting a tempo as well. And this is extremely weakening, and this is not taking the free piece. Alright. More strangeness coming in. Why did he not take here? What's going on? I don't get it. I don't get anything. What's happening? Knight f5 as well, allowing this bishop. Taking here with some obscure threats. Just take. Yeah, I'm not liking what either side is playing. Whoa! Rook e7 at knight c5. Wow. Okay, the blunders are happening early on. But here, white is utterly dominating. I think queen f4 was a bit stronger, but this is mating as well. Yeah, rook e8 is coming. Rook e8 will hurt. Queen d7, yep. Nice job. Nice job. Alright. Doctor, what's up, Samer? Hello. Yeah, so, already a tight score, but that game featured some high-level blunders. Alright, so, giving up. Yeah, transitioning from a isolated queen's pawn position to hanging pawn's position. And this bishop you should play against. c5 you should try to not allow. c5 is not, yeah, c5 is being allowed for no reason. Knight f5. I get that attacks some squares, but what is it really doing? Okay, this just drops a piece. Okay, bishop c6. He should have just moved bishop f8. Yeah, now this is a piece drop, and look at the bishop pair. Amazing. Yeah, not going to work out well here, I think. So yeah, it's first to 25, by the way, guys, because this is a bullet war. So first to 25. Yeah, no, it's just a piece up, and now it's two pieces up. One of them being a heavy piece, that is the rook. So, okay, rook e7 here, just attack f8. This is also completely. Rook e7? Rook e7. No, rook e7. He's going after the a4 pawn instead, okay. Everything is completely winning. I like rook c5, trying to trade pieces, make the conversion easier. But hey, he needs to speed up. What is this? He's taking 1 second a move. Come on, speed up. Rook a1 is very unnecessary. Just push the pawn. Yeah, let's go. Let's go. Yes. Oh. Okay, now at least he can't lose, but I'm afraid he will draw with this time usage. Yo, don't allow stalemate. Oof, queen g4. Awesome, mate. Nice. Nice find. Nice find by Antoine. Okay, he's playing the Owens. The Owens. By the way, something I've been forgetting to do in Chess Wars is to switch sides, switch perspectives while viewing the games. So that is something I shall do. That's something I shall do. Okay, the Owens. So yeah, white gets a big center, but black here isn't suffering from typical Owens problems. Okay, takes, 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 and now bishop h7. He doesn't even bother with taking d5. That's quite nice seeing the tactic and judging that it's not so good because there was takes and then the queen would have taken this guy. Okay, now maybe b3 is very good because queen h4 was threatening mate and the bishop, but now the bishop is covered. Okay, but now this diagonal could tell some very sad tales for white, but for now d5 is very well protected. Very well protected. This transition though makes d5 much weaker. Oh, already here you could have taken. Yeah, you can take now. And this is coming, this is game over actually. Rook e3 covers that square, very nice. This is just blundering a pawn. Okay, not captured. Ooh, this is blundering another pawn. No, queen b3, never mind. Rook c3 is a bit strange because I don't like this rook being unprotected, but for now it's fine. Oh yeah, this back rank tactic wasn't working. Okay, now it's just the queen up. I guess this will be. Yeah, here, very important. Just keep your queen on dark squares to avoid anything with the bishop. Okay. Never mind that. If your opponent blunders. Yeah, give these pawns some breathing room so that you don't stalemate, and yeah. Antoine, not falling for any stalemates. Not falling for any stalemates. Hello, David Fassbinder. We missed you, man. So now we're taking a look at the Scandinavian with bishop g4. A line I don't like because of h3, g4, knight e5. But yeah, white castle, so now h3, g4 isn't happening. Okay, this maneuver going to f4 is interesting, or g3. Kind of reminds one of the Ruy Lopez, huh? This maneuver. This kind of maneuver to f1 and stuff like that. Okay, this g5 was a very nice move by Captain Price. But now knight e4 is coming. Okay, this is trying to win the pawn, the bishop, I mean. But. Knight e4 is much better. Come on, you have to play knight e4. This is just trading and helping. Yeah, this is getting rid. These are superfluous knights because they're covering the same square. So this knight, the knight here, would rather be here instead of its brethren knight. So yeah, removing one of these knights is not so good. Okay, but he's transitioning to a winning rook endgame now. Yeah, this passed pawn is going to fly. A4 is not even necessary. Yeah, this is just not really necessary. Just push. Just push. Yeah, okay, he's pushing the G pawn. Yeah, sure, why not? Rook G4, awesome. Nice. Yeah, Antoine is playing amazingly. By the way, Antoine is quite high rated in Blitz compared to Captain Price. Captain Price, I think, is 1500 in Blitz. Yes, Captain Price is 1500 in Blitz. But Antoine is 1700, and I think he's reached. I'm almost certain he reached 1800. Or something close to that. So there's a pretty big difference in terms of Blitz. But in terms of bullet, it's a bit closer. But still, this is. The Blitz prowess is showing, so it was a tied match, then Antoine won 3 games. Okay, but still early days. We can't judge this match as of yet, it's still very early days. Rook b8 trying to pick up the pawn. Why is it not being picked up? c4 is a terrible move. You need to break down white center, not close the center. Yeah, now there really is nothing on the king side. Yeah, especially now there's much less. Okay, but h4, h5, you should be careful of. Taking b2 is very tone deaf, let's say. Okay, but rook f1, what is rook f1? Now rook f5 is possible. But then maybe rook c3. Rook c3, I think, yeah, rook c3, I think, was working. Okay, here he's trying to go for, like, kind of a mate, but not really. Not really a mate. Okay, maybe queen b2 trying to. Okay. Ah, clever, clever. Okay. Yeah, very nice play by Antoine. Very nice play. Picking up the exchange. Now it's an entire rook. An entire rook. Yeah, this is a done deal. C3. Okay, I'll keep checking, waste his time a bit. Yeah, just push C3, C2. King H8, wow. Alright. Yeah, anything was winning there though. Yeah, here King H4, King H5 will eventually get mated. And probably like 2-3 moves, I think. Anyway. Captain Price going for the Sicilian and we're seeing a Grand Prix. Alright. 5-1 for Antoine. So a Grand Prix. Let me check on streaming health. Oh, I'm dropping lots of frames. Yikes. Why though? That sucks. Yeah, I've dropped a bit of frames, but okay. Okay, what we gotta do? Happens. I don't know what's up with the internet today. Maybe because it rained a bit. Yeah, it's raining in June, by the way. Okay, so white is getting a huge attack and black is not castled. I would just castle queenside and try to survive. E5, very nice. Extremely nice move. Okay, but maybe a check is being allowed. But then D4. Yeah. Whoa! That's a bit much. Yeah, okay. I mean, he shouldn't have taken. He should have taken this knight. Yeah, now just check. And still not clear how you proceed, though. Yeah, what do you do now? Knight B5. Whoa, Rook G2. Yeah, Antoine is dropping so many pieces, but one second. Ooh, the queen was hanging, buddy. Okay, yeah, this is he's just flagging him. All right. Yeah, that was quite a close game. Okay, so another caro. And this time somewhat of an exchange. Yeah, this should. Oh, taking with the pawn is very strange. Why not with the knight? I don't get that. Yeah, bishop g5, now you have to play f6. Okay, yeah, you don't have to play f6, right. Okay, queen b6 should come. Rook e8, okay. Oh, just dropping the pawn. I guess d4 was hanging though. Oh, and the queen was hanging. What am I talking about? Yeah, but now dropping this pawn. But then you take here, I guess. Yeah, this is just level. This is just level. Maybe black has a slight pull. These pawns are very strange, by the way. Okay, I'll just go here. And this king f8 has actually helped black, as this is an end game and black is getting some improved activity. Knight c2 maybe should have been played. Okay, now maybe f4 and knight takes c2. Okay, no. Trading, oh, I don't like trading. Or at least follow up with knight b4, forking these two pawns. Yeah, but none of that is being played. Knight b4 now. Knight d4, rather. Yeah, I'm dropping lots of frames. Hopefully the stream quality is still fine, if anyone can confirm. Yeah, Antoine, by the way, is dominating on the clock in all games. All games he's dominating on the clock. Yeah, this just makes your pawns doubled for no reason. Ooh, g4 though was a bit unnecessary, but yeah, he's flagging him. Okay, why is he not playing king c4? He should have played that sooner. Yeah, still completely winning. Okay, last trick by Captain Price, but yeah, not enough, not enough. He's too quick on time. He's too up on time. in most games. Yeah, here we're seeing, oof, f6. Yeah, already the Damiano defense, right, guys? Already knight takes e5 is a thing, apparently. The Damiano defense. The quality is fine, but I had to refresh it sometimes. Yeah, it's... no, it's due to my internet connection, David, unfortunately. it's a problem at some points in the game. Now it seems fine, though. Don't jinx it. Let's not jinx it. By the way, David, how's your novel writing going? Have you made any progress? Okay, here, yeah, queen b3. Just attack these two light square weaknesses. He tries, yeah, now the king can't castle. By the way, it's an opposite colored bishop position, but white has a huge edge because there's no safety. Okay, trading queens, though, I don't like. Why are you trading pieces? With the queens on the board, actually, there's the saying, opposite colored bishop middle games favor the attacking side. While opposite colored bishop end games are usually drawish. Okay, dropping a4. Take a4. Take a4. Here I think he can't take here. Yes. Very nice. Very nice. Wow. And now rook b1. Ooh, we might be seeing a comeback. As long as he plays quickly. Yeah, this entire sequence only wins a piece, but yeah, now it's in complete time scramble. Actually, the speed, Antoine is just flying. Never mind, it's evening up. Okay, come on, faster. Let's see some speed. Whoa, no speed. This is insane. 8-1. 7-0 run for Antoine. Slow progress. Yeah, better than no progress. Whoa. Yeah, I think the transition from game to game is hurting my stream somehow. The internet isn't being able to keep up with the change. Yikes. That sucks. Another one of these Caro Kanns. And again, yeah, here he's dropping a pawn. And Captain Price hasn't been playing these Caro Kanns very well. He's just leaving too many dark square weaknesses. Usually. I call these dark squares. And they're being used by Antoine. And here he's picking up a pawn. Rook c1 though offers some hope of counterplay. But then just... Oh, dropping the rook. Wow. Yeah, David, I greatly liked the subject matter. It seems very... novel, pun intended. Whoa, bishop c5, dropping the bishop. Yikes. I want to switch to Captain Price's perspective. Yeah, so, wow, he's played 8-3 check games, okay. Awesome. Yeah, so, I want to see how the novel goes and... see what are the options of buying it. Okay. Five, oh, not even. He's down a pawn even and an entire rook. That's so sad. And time. Yeah, this is complete domination. 9-1. 9-1. I need to remind you guys. Antoine started at about 1550. And Captain Price was about 1400. Okay, so we're seeing a new opening this time. G6 against E4, the modern. And transitioning back into some sort of Sicilian. B5 dropping a pawn, but... Queen B5 maybe isn't... it's a bit, maybe a bit greedy, but no, I would have taken that, to be honest. Okay, here he is. Nah, I don't see how helpful that is. Just take... Oh. Giving up the knight. Yeah. Captain Price not doing well at all here. Queen c6 check, yes, forcing the king to move to a bad square. And what's it going to be? Knight d3, where is the knight coming? Maybe to f4? Okay, yeah, just queen c6. Probably rook c8. Okay, king f7. Yeah, knight e5 and knight c6 check, maybe. No, no need. No need. Okay, he's down a piece, but he's keeping even on time. So that's good. G5 is just weakening every single square on the board, though. Okay, what black needs to play is rook c6 and rook c8. I don't know why he's not playing that. He gets out of the fork on g6. That could have happened. Now, yeah, this seems... After rook f7, he was threatening a nasty mate, by the way. Ooh, but yeah, this is why I wanted to play rook c7, rook c8. Okay, this is allowing king e7, forking two pieces. Not forking. But he drops the rook instead. Oh, but Captain Price. Or am I lagging? Ooh, he fell for the checkmate. Yeah, I lagged there as well. Man, what's happening with the internet? So annoying. 10-1. Antoine is almost adopting the guy. Yeah, so here, that was Captain Price's game to win, but this mate, this is called the hookmate, if you guys want to look it up. The hookmate, yes. I hope that it will be published and then I will let you know, but it is in German. Ooh. Okay, that's a bummer. That's a bummer for us English speakers. I was about to say English only speakers, but obviously I speak many other languages. Not many, but some. Just G3, man. Get out of the mate. G3. Yo, G3. Yes. Okay, but trading all the minor majors, I wouldn't have done. Just after the check, just go king g2. No need to take. Yeah, rook c6. Try to come up with your king, maybe to f4, e5, if at all possible. Okay, king, what is this? Just allowing a2 promotion. Yeah, this is utter domination by Antoine. And, like, utterly insane. Can't fathom what's happening. He's already adopted him. What in the world? Is it? No, 9. This is a 9, yeah. Oh, and I could have subtracted from the score. Why am I being stupid? Yeah, but Antoine will win this game and that's adoption. Now in Bullet Wars it's 25 games for adoption. In Blitz it's 10. But still, this can be counted as adoption. In other chess circles, 10 games in a row and bullet. Yeah, so already an adoption, 11-1. He needs 14 games to win the match, but now it's not even about winning the match, it's about saving face. Saving face. Captain Price needs to pick up a game. What's happening? So many games missed. Well, David, I hope it's a success and. You're able to translate it to English and other languages, of course. If not, I could always... Who knows, maybe by then, by the time you're finished publishing it, I can... I would be able to read some German. Because I plan on studying German, but not very soon. I have other languages first. Latin and Esperanto. Yeah, by the way, here, instead of rook d1, knight check was a move, because after takes, there's queen takes. But that was missed. Rook e6 protects against that. Now it's being... Oh, what is this, though? Yeah, this is a bad move by Captain Price. This is rough. Yeah, this is terribly rough. I mean, I get Antoine is 200 rating points stronger in bullet, but in blitz, but they were almost similarly rated in bullet. Not similarly, but reasonably close. But now look at this, like complete domination, and the rook is hanging. Whoa, queen's hanging. Rook was hanging. Okay, but he's missing some stuff. Oh, queen takes instead of bishop takes. Okay, but see here, Captain Price is just too slow. Come on, man. You need to pick up the pace. You can't, like, if he gives you these minor chances in the time scrambles, you need to take them. Yeah, Captain Price, he's being slower during the game. In the time scramble, he's playing worse. Antoine is just playing out of his mind. I don't understand the score nor what is happening on the board. It's crazy. This is one of the most, like, on paper close affairs that end up being one-sided. Okay, dropping a pawn as well. Yeah, Captain Price is just collapsing. And now I'm afraid d4 will be coming. Okay, at least he gets out of that. But queen e5, nice. Threatening mate and the queen trade. So he trades the queen. Yeah, okay. d4 was always in the air, but not so good. Okay, now you have to play c3. Now he's dropping a pawn. Oh no. Rook c8. Rook c1, maybe. Antoine doesn't even blunder with bishop takes c2. Okay, he does. Man, the internet is... Like, why does it have to do this when I'm watching Bullet War? Come on. 9%. Wow, terrible. Yeah, there was this here. Missed by Captain Price. So, Antoine is actually blundering sometimes. It's not that he's not blundering, but Captain Price is just not making use of those blunders. And now he's down. Oof, trading? No, never trade. A rook endgame, never trade, never trade. Hello, Nsamo, what's up? Yeah, never trade in a rook endgame, it's just... Yeah, Antoine not leaving, wow. 13-1, okay. Okay. He resigns. David says, Truth Doctor, you are a real studying berserk. Esperanto, Latin, chess, and I guess a lot more. Yeah, man. My days are packed. My days are packed. Yeah, a lot more. Yeah, biology, philosophy. I'm reading quite a bit of stuff. And... some ventures, like for example computer science, and again, and yeah, fixing the internet, that would be a start. Ooh, no. no, looking like 14-1. It's terrible. Now we're up to 10% dropped frames. I keep taking a look at OBS every few seconds, every few minutes. And it was at 5% dropped frames, now then 6%, then 7%, 8%, 9%, 10%. God. Ooh, but allowing attack. Why not take the rook, man? Oh my god, Captain Price is missing every single chance he's getting. This is just sad to watch. Yeah, nice. Queen of Fate, leaving no chances. Antoine is playing just brutal chess. I mean, this could have been an adoption war. Seriously, what's happening? Captain Price, I think it's a mix of tilt and... Okay, Antoine is probably the stronger play. Ooh! Oh no, what's Captain Price doing though? Okay, we're going to see a real time scramble here. Oof. Finally, Captain Price gets a game. Okay. But that was a complete collapse by Antoine, but yeah, finally breaking the streak here. The captain seems on crazy tilt, yes. It's a mix of everything. Tilt, being outplayed in the specific openings. Sometimes your opponent's opening choice in a match can be very annoying for you, and this is a good case of this. Bishop e3. Bad. And this allowing bishop. Okay, but check. No, you can't trade queens, man. It's just hopeless. Keep the queens on the board. Play queen a4 check here. Play queen a4 check here. Yeah, actually, that would have offered quite some good chances because the king would have to move. Yikes. Yeah, he's rounding up the pawn. Just the rook keeps following the pawn. Okay, but this maneuver by Captain Price was nice. I don't get what... Okay, he's trying, yeah, to get the king and maybe rook. I don't know. Don't see a clear setup. How do you pick up the pawn? Yeah, he's not seeing a clear setup either. Okay. Of course, Antoine shouldn't draw this. He should be careful. Yeah, he's moving the bishop. Okay, why not take the pawn g3? I don't get that. I'm just moving too quickly. But these blunders with hanging queens and rooks are far off his real rating and strength, I guess. Yeah, it's just too much. Like, you expect players at this rating. Whoa, a draw. Yeah, that's... Okay, Antoine was really down on time, but... Yeah. He shouldn't have done that. But yeah, Captain Price is not making a comeback, but okay, he's alive in the match, on the board. Picking up a pawn now, okay. Yeah. Still, the Scandi is... Like... Okay, no, I wouldn't say White still has an advantage, but... Maybe it's not too bad, because White is pretty happy in the Scandi usually. Okay, now this is venturing into worse and worse territory. Why take with the queen and not the knight, man? Develop a piece and protect the center. And Samo, do you have a preferred date for your match against superfluous bishops, your adoption war? By the way, let's switch back to Antoine's perspective. I haven't asked him yet, actually, but if he doesn't accept, there is Jokesing One, who was up for it as well. He's similarly rated. But superfluous bishops never shies away from matches, so I'm expecting him to accept. Before or after streamer battle? No, let's do it before. The streamer battle is in 4 days from now, so plenty of time. Okay, dropping a pawn here by Captain Price. He's doing well on the clock though, maintaining some degree of closeness. Okay, I'm happy to report that Antoine collapsing now. Nice for Captain Price. Let's see the speed, though. If he loses this, it's going to sting. Because this is the game for him. This is the game. Yeah, but Antoine is flying. Never mind. Slowing down a bit. Okay, the queen is coming. Ooh, Antoine might get this. Oof, wow, that was really close. I think Antoine, the problem that happened here is he didn't find a legal move. Had he found one? Yeah, but nice. Captain Price is coming back, yeah. Okay, this setup always play e5 and try to go for e4 and just control the center. Knight f5 just dropping a pawn, yeah. Antoine is collapsing. f5 or d5? Probably d5, of course, yeah, right? Take the pawn in the center. Or pick up two of them. That's better. Yeah, is that... Ooh. Ouch. Yeah. He's coming back. Captain Price is not going down without a fight. That little skirmish in the middle, just forget about it. Captain Price is coming back. Okay, so tomorrow with the internet. It might not even be an internet issue, I need to check it. Anyway, so when Sama was saying, yeah, tomorrow there might be game over, bro, against Dr. 1000 IQ, a chess war, very high rated chess war. So the day after tomorrow is quite good, yeah. So the day after tomorrow, on Thursday. Friday, we have some other things. Yeah, Friday, Saturday, Sunday is packed with tournaments. Okay, Antoine doing well here, picking up a piece. I would have played rook e1, just maintain control of the open file. Yeah, dropping frames even now. It's terrible what's happening with the internet, I don't know. Okay, seems to be a bit better though now. Ooh, rook b6 dropping the rook. Bad. This is bad. Alright, so let's see the conversion. For now, Antoine hasn't dropped a single stalemate, so not leaving any chances. Not leaving a single chance. And now mate, rook h1. Nice pattern recognition as well by Antoine. Not going for the queen or anything, just noticing that this is mate. Amazing, amazing. Okay, let's see what's going on here. Yeah, this reminds one. Is it working? I don't think it's working. Yeah, you pick up the rook in the corner. My internet lagged, so I didn't hear your response. With the internet problems I have today, I think it might be mine. Or did you also lag when I was saying something? Anyway, yeah, so the day after tomorrow in Samo is what I was saying is good. Yeah, here black is just down in exchange. But okay, with the rook activity though, the rook coming to e4, c4. Yeah, this is quite bad. This, yeah, now bishop e3 check. Rook c4, yes. If you have to play b5, there is rook c6 check. Nice. And Captain Price spots that. Awesome, man. Good luck, by the way. I don't want to wish that you have a son, because that would be bad for superfluous bishops. But yeah, just good luck. Knight f4. Yeah, d4 was a nice move. D4 was a nice move. Knight takes g2. Okay. Yeah, g4 check is not really doing anything. Just giving up a pawn for some semblance of activity that is not really there, but. Actually, the time is quite in Antoine's favor, yeah, and he's picking up, oof. Now it's only, oh, and he's dropping every single piece. Whoa. Yeah, if Captain Price is not winning that game, this is going to be a very tough. F4, G4 against the Scandi, that's... Yeah, Antoine is taking his liberties now, after having dominated the score so much. He can afford to lose a few games. So he's taking his liberties, trying to test the borders of what could happen here. Yeah, knight b5 is a bit of a strange move. Queen b4, trading queens. Yeah, don't take with the knight, because now knight b4... Oh, the knight was hanging, though. Okay, but what about bishop c6 there? Wasn't played. a3, but now you're allowing knight d5. This is a bit unnecessary. Could take back, and if knight d5 now, just king c3. Yeah, not allowing knight takes c3 check is a bit unnecessary here. Just, oh, why is he not playing knight takes c3 check? Now he's just down an exchange. And it's the easiest exchange here. Yeah, rook f1 trading queens and not good. Not good. Back to lagging with the internet as well. Not good for my internet either. Okay, what's happening here? By the way, Fishy, how can your stream get the front page of Free Chess? You just have to send an application. Having a title makes it 10 times easier. I think almost all titled players get accepted because they're just quite strong. Yeah, okay, some titled players aren't so strong. But I mean, those that apply are quite strong. And you need to interact with the chat and stuff like that. But I think for Ara, oof, why a6, why not queen takes d5? I guess there's knight c3, but then queen e5. Okay. Yeah, this is a very weird variation. Look at this lone queenside pawn. It makes for a very strange impression. A very strange impression indeed. Yeah, and Samo, so I think if you're going to apply because it's great. What's great? I missed that. Oh, yeah, David interpreted that as being my stream. Yeah, I got in Samo. He meant the stream in general, yes. Yeah, and Samo, if you want to apply for the Arabic streamers, I think you'll easily get that. First of all, because there aren't many others, and by the way, the queen of Captain Price bids you a farewell from Sheol. So yeah, what was I saying? Yeah, so you'll easily get that, I think, and Samo, because there aren't many Arabic streamers. And you fulfill all criteria, I think. Okay, just check and queen takes b3. Over. Completely over. Wow, knight, rook takes c4 check. Yeah, you can afford that. And that's actually a good move in this position. Okay, and the bishop does a good job of protecting against rook c8, rook a8. So we're not going to see any accidents, I don't think. Yeah, okay, that's a bit unnecessary if you're going to play slowly. Okay, Antoine needs to pick up the time. Yeah, let's switch to Captain Price's perspective. Antoine flags. Oh my god. Yeah, he only has himself to blame for losing that. Dropping the queen was not necessary at all. Oh, and Samo, I'm so sorry. I've watched your streams and I forgot you stream in English. What's wrong with me? I'm sorry, I'm just really annoyed by this internet connection issue. 8% dropped frames. Yeah, where are the games? Rematch offer accepted? Am I not? Somehow it's even accepting my ability to look at the TV. What's this? Black castling queenside so early? In the Sicilian? Castling queenside in the Sicilian. Wow. Okay. Yeah, that's not supposed to be good. What? That's not supposed to be good because in the Sicilian you want... But this is a closed Sicilian, so... It's not supposed to be good in the open because you take here and the c-file becomes open for you. Semi-open, so... You don't want to castle there. But here it's closed, so it makes more sense. And Antoine sacrificing a piece for no real reason. Yeah, but okay, no. Actually, Captain Price is defending quite well, but dropping f7, not so well. If I have good rating, will my chances be higher? Wow, he drops the queen. So, we were due to have technical issues, right? Yeah, by the way, c takes d4 is just winning a pawn and making. Yeah, queen e7 is unnecessary. And c4? Whoa, why not c takes d4? What's he doing? I get he's trying to attack, but. Yeah, so a higher rating definitely helps your chances. And knight b4 is a nice move, threatening a fork on a2, by the way. And interacting with the chat, of course. Knight d3, and b2 is collapsing, and after it a3 as well. Yeah, ouch. Yeah, queen a3 now. Even c3 check, then queen a3 is interesting as well. But yeah, just queen a3. Queen d3, c3 now. Bishop e7, you really want to castle, no? Okay, I can appreciate that. I can appreciate that. Okay, queen b2 is the threat now. Gets out of it. Takes c2, but flag instead. And no, David, it's. I don't know what's happening with the internet today. Hasn't happened in a month, as I've said. Look at how slow it is. Ah. The red in OBS, CPU usage. So many dropped frames. Wow, terrible. Absolutely terrible. Sure, in Samo. But you use funny language to state that. The request is fine, of course. Yeah, and besides, you mean the video, so I will be the one commentating, right? So, of course, that's completely fine. Oh my god, this internet is just. So annoying. I just want to enjoy some bullet and stream it. Can I just not do that? Am I allowed to do that? Come on, stream. Come on, internet. Yeah, so many dropped frames. At least you can, when this happens, you can listen to the audio, so it's fine. I guess. Yeah, opposite card, bishop endgame. Actually, black stands better here. Because, yeah, be careful of d5. Be careful of d5. The ship has sailed on d5 though. Now just put. He loses on time. That's so sad. 20 and a half, 4 and a half. 4.5 more points for Antoine, and he picks up the war. The war will be picked up. Yeah, look, when we transition to a game, the dropped frames increase. And hopefully that fixes it. Actually, wow, looks like it improved greatly. Okay, don't count your chickens before they've hatched. Expect the worst and be happy when it doesn't happen. Seems good so far. Hopefully you guys haven't left the chat. Okay. So we missed the win by Captain Price, unfortunately. He really dominated that game. But now we're looking at this game. Still here, David. Thank you a lot, man. Bearing through these tough times of the stream. So annoying. But thankfully, I think they're past us. Yeah, zero dropped frames. Good heavens. 93 was probably better to pick up, knight g4 rather, to pick up e3. But okay, this way. Knight c5 is cute. Not really doing much after the queen moves though. You have to move back. But yeah, cute nonetheless. Yeah, you could consider queen b6, but that's only helping white. Yeah, this is a tactic. And by the way, b7 was possible because takes, there's rook a7. And then you're threatening rook a8, so that was a done deal. B7 now. Okay, sacrificing. Good practical decision. Sad thing is, though, he couldn't take b6 because, again, of the back rank mate, so. Completely dead. Here, just. No, never mind. Okay, but look at the time. Antoine is so down on time. Just a check will kill him, yeah. Just a check will kill off this game. Captain Price n refusing to go down. 6.5. Still way far behind, but he is riding the ship. He's correcting this. Okay, but this is terrible. Why not knight c6? This is terrible for white. When you get the bishop on d4 in these structures and allow knight c6, and especially knight takes d4 at some point, it's just bad. Okay, g4. Yeah, trying to go for some activity. Bishop c5 now. My apologies, but yeah, won't be enough. And Samu, are you still in the chat room? If you replied, oh, b4 picking up a piece. Yeah, Captain Price doing well here. And Samu, if you're still in the chat room, I didn't see what you replied with. Why do that? I am like, okay, you're up an entire rook here, but no need. No need, especially in bullet. You'd think in bullet that would be better, but I mean, you're not going to drop anything there. It's so completely safe, the position. Yeah, here you're kind of afraid. I would have rather taken with the rook there, but okay, but with the passed pawn, yeah. Rook check, a bit unnecessary, but still. Queen b8. Yes, nice. He's finding the mate. Nice. Captain Price with 3 wins in a row. Tres. Hasn't happened yet, actually. Hasn't happened. 7.5. He's making. He's. Ma Comeback might be real, guys. Comeback might be real. Antoine needs to. Okay, c6, c5, what's that? Why play c5? e5 drops a pawn. Yeah, bishop check now, and you pick up the pawn. Okay, that was not seen. Now black stands better with bishop g4 as a possibility. Now you have to play knight c6 back. Now you're dropping e5 again. Still dropping e5. Knight g6. Still dropping e5. Okay, and finally Antoine takes that. Queen there. Trading queens when you're down a pawn. And losing. My apologies, losing another pawn. Yeah, Captain Price ruining this comeback now. Okay. 0 dropped frames. When was this? Now the internet is perfect. God. I'm happy, but I'm a bit sad I didn't think of. Restarting the internet when the problem first occurred. wasn't too quick on my feet there. Okay, this position, white should retain an edge despite blundering back the pawn, thanks to his bishop and the fragmented pawns, which the bishop can aid. But yeah, with the knight, you can waste a lot of time. But even with the knight, whoa, Captain Price is just too slow in time scrambles. He always like loses a second. I don't know if this is due to connection issues or just being inexperienced at bullet. Now 21.5, 7.5. It's almost a done deal, I would say. Because he needs how many draws? 7 draws. Okay, 7 draws is maybe a bit much. Especially as we're not seeing many draws. If you look at the scoreboard, there's only one draw in the past 20 games. The displayed number is 20, right? Yeah. Ooh, picking up the knight here, though. I would not take. That's only helping black. Yeah, 5 now. I would have not taken. I would have retreated bishop f2. Knight f4, dropping the knight g6. Ouch. Yeah, from dropping the knight to forking the entire... the royal fork. To having now... Okay, yeah, I was thinking... Rook takes e4. Yikes. h3 is a cute move. He finds it. Yeah, now where's the mate? He's still escaping a bit. This would be tragic if he doesn't... Okay, but come on. Queen b3. Queen b3, man. Now, queen d2. Look at the king, by the way, on c1. The king is on c1. Yeah, Captain Price, slowly but surely, coming back to a store near you. Why are they not playing? Are they taking a break? What's going on? Antoine is probably a bit tilted from what's happening. He was rather dominating and he's allowing Captain Price a bit back in the match. The past 5 games, it has been 4-1 for Captain Price, so... Yeah, very funny mate, actually. Very rare as well for this to occur. So, yeah. What's going on? Are they taking a bit of a break? I'm being kept in the dark here. No one is messaging me or... Antoine is online. Captain Price is online. Let's see if we can message them. Okay, let's also not bore you guys. Let's put some game. Yeah, kind of unbelievable that it was even legal to get the king on c1. That's what David Fassbinder said. That's 100% true, man. This is exactly what I was thinking. Like, how could the king get to c1? Okay, so we're watching a bit of a higher rated bullet match. Bullet war, maybe. Bushido Naruto against Sumsar 42. 42, was he really born in the year 42? With a 2700 bullet rating, I somehow doubt that. Just a casual 78-year-old playing such high-level bullet? Possible. But not very likely. You'd have to be in pretty good health at 78 to be able to play bullet at that level. And unfortunately, many aren't. Okay, so... Have they started? Oh, they've... No, they haven't started yet. Wow, this is quite a long break. I guess maybe a smoke break, right? Something I don't encourage, by the way. If you don't smoke, never smoke, please. And if you do smoke, try to quit. Queen b6, trying to pick up b2. Honestly, should be taken. Knight f7, bishop e6, yeah. Oh, bishop, knight h6, I didn't see that. But still, the knight is trapped. Funny, funny. Oh, but he finds a tactical solution. But still, I think black stands better here. He's up a pawn, and I don't see the attack really happening. And I like this bishop on f7, protecting everything. Okay, now he dropped the pawn. But queen takes b2, maybe? Queen takes b2? Wait. Was that not possible? That's awesome to hear, Antoine. Oh. Yeah, it's not 20, man. It's still 25. If it were till 20, you would have finished already. So, that's why I found it a bit weird you stopped at 21 and a half. Those are just rumors, I think, David, started by Nigel Short, a very questionable figure. David is asking, aren't there the rumors that the old Bob Fischer played online chess anonymously? Yeah. Just rumors, I think, started by Nigel Short. I think the account on ICC was probably just using an engine to beat Nigel Short in those games. Why would it be Bobby Fischer out of all people anyway? It doesn't make really much sense. And you'd think these really top players have so many accounts and stuff like that. But Kramnik, for example, I doubt he plays much anonymously. Kramnik. Vichy, for example, I doubt as well. They really just don't play online chess. Old school people. Magnus, for example, he doesn't play much online chess. He probably has a few secret accounts, but I don't think he plays much online chess anyway. Right. So Antoine, are you going to play? Antoine, you still have to play till 25. Where are you, buddy? Not complaining though, I'm watching some high level chess here. But we need to get back to the war, man. It's not over yet. And we've suffered through too many internet disconnections to stop here. Yeah, meanwhile, pretty close match between these two. Even though Sumsar is rated 150 rating points lower than Mr. Bushido Naruto. Bushido Naruto. Oh, yeah, now I got the name. Bushido, the way of the samurai. And Naruto. The anime. I think they've started. Yep. Taking with the d-pawn here, quite interesting. Activating the bishop, kind of. e5, dropping a pawn. Not taken. Now it's taken. Yeah, I've noticed that Captain Price keeps dropping this e5 pawn, huh? Be careful. Be very careful. Be careful, look after, no, bishop d4 is being missed. Ah, that pains me. Yeah, but knight d1 at least improved things. Yeah, this isn't so easy to convert, by the way. c4 is excellent though. It's an excellent step forward, c5. Yeah, go in with your king. I'm liking what Captain Price is doing very much. Yeah, just domination here. Whoa. just domination. He's trying to zugzwang him. That's amazing. And now he gets a passed pawn. Captain Price played this like a friggin' GM. We were seeing two GMs play. Captain Price played this even better. Ooh, but he missed the mating pattern there. And he's going, oh my god, he's going to flag. Oh my god, that's so sad. Oh, that's tragic. That's tragic. He played that conversion. He converted this far better than I would ever convert this. And probably as good as Grandmaster would. That was amazing. Just keeping everything tied up. And, wow. Yeah, but Antoine, really. And missing the mating pattern at the end there with Rook H8. That cost him the game. Yeah, Antoine doing a nice job here to come back. We're seeing this kind of Peart's position. Yeah, now knight takes d5. Knight takes d5, man. Knight takes d5 now, yes. And you take on e7. You have to play knight c6. You have to play knight c6. Don't play king h8. He plays king. Oh, come on. What's happening, Antoine? Antoine. I pronounced, ooh, queen h6, by the way, would have ended the game. I pronounced Antoine's name in the American way. French would be Antoine. Yeah, but he gets a mate as well. Okay, still keeping this within bounds, Captain Price. Still keeping this within bounds. Okay, another weird. He never takes e5, that's so funny. And f6 is just tragically weakening every square. But now d5 is possible. g6, I guess, also possible. Yeah, Captain Price plays a very cute setup against the. In the Sicilian of his. With this kind of fianchetto. It's very unique. And Antoine always like threatening to open up the position here and here, but he closes it up instead. So weird, just closing up his own play. Yeah, now the black king is perfectly safe. And now you could see an attack coming. Yeah, this is where both of them losses in the last 7 games, time losses in a winning game for Captain Price. That may very well be the case, David Fassbinder, actually. He has lost, I think, over 3 to 4 games in completely winning positions. And almost equal time in the time scramble. And just Antoine flies while Captain Price takes a heckload of time. Yeah, but here I think this is an endgame he will convert. Okay, but see here, he's taking so much time. What's he doing? That was unnecessary. He could have played rook c3. Yeah, look at this. He spends a second on almost every move. Look at this. Oh my god. Oh my god, Captain Price. I don't know if it's connection issues or... This is an unbelievable time usage. Yeah, exactly what David said here. Just a winning position that turned into a drawish position. And then he spends like a second on every move. Maybe he doesn't have pre-move enabled. That could actually be the case. He's very new to bullet. And chess in general. Both of them are. So that may very well be the case. Okay, what do we have here? A fork for one. D4 was... Oh, the knight is pinned. My bad, guys. But now this is a piece. And Captain Price, no need to trade pieces when you're down a piece. That's only helpful for the other side. For okay, but Queen G3 pinning. Okay, Queen. Yeah, Queen G6 gets out of it. How new are they? Oh, Bishop C2, Queen C2 is not possible, by the way. Queen on G6 is doing a nice job protecting that. How new are they? Captain Price, let me try to remember how old is Captain Price now. I think he's been playing, both of them have been casual players for the past 2 years, I think. 2 years is about right. Dropping the queen. Yeah, this is 24 and a half. The match, I think, is effectively over. I don't think Captain Price will win 14 games in a row. Looks quite tough. Yeah, and Antoine hasn't stalemated not even once. Actually, to be fair, Captain Price as well. So, yeah, that's quite nice for players in their rating range not to stalemate. That's quite impressive, actually. Yeah, thing is, the past 2 to 3 years, they've been casual players, not really studying the game, not having any guidance, just enjoying it casually, which is, of course, something that's quite good. But now I think they've decided, both of them, to get their name, maybe their name as well, to the next level, to improve their game to new heights. Yeah, I like, not like, but I don't mind Captain Price's position here. Will Antoine drop mate? No. No, he doesn't leave any chances. Rook h2 is suicidal. Yeah, I don't get rook h2. Queen f3, there's knight g4. But still, black is winning. White is winning. Yeah, now he plays knight g4 without anything to back it up. Queen f5 trading, yeah, this is over. I think the match is over now. Looking like 25 and a half, 20 and a half. And the same idea by Antoine, getting this rook here to trade it. This is something we've seen before in the match. Antoine just being very accurate. Yeah. No stalemate. Don't expect Antoine to... Taking on d3, by the way, is a bullet error. Because here you want to use the pawn to try to hide behind it and try to get a stalemate that way. Taking it only helps him. And now he's doing the stepladder. Oh, but Antoine blundered. Okay, but still, too much, yeah. Yeah, he's not blundering this. Over 25 and a half, 9 and a half. Congratulations to Antoine. Antoine. Congratulations, my friend. Captain Price, tough luck. You made a nice comeback many times, but it wasn't enough. Now, Antoine is, of course, 200, 300 rating points stronger in Blitz. So, the score still a bit surprising, but not too surprising. But, yeah, a lot of things to learn for Captain Price, especially the time usage at the end there. Maybe if you don't have pre-move enabled, enable it and... course, that's a huge difference in bullet, and you need to pick up the pace and time scrambles and earlier as well, and yeah, just some very small errors people of this rating range make. Yeah, okay, very enjoyable. Thankfully the internet connection issues were fixed after I restarted the internet, which I wish I would have done before, but yeah, that's in the past now. We had fun, that's the most important part, even though the internet annoyed me a bit. And the Antoine Musa saying GG's in the chat. Yeah man, awesome games, thanks a lot for the match, and yeah, hopefully we get to see a rematch sometime soon. Okay guys, I'll be stopping the stream. Take care, goodbye, see ya.